Alrighty, due through a couple of video glitches and bits and pieces, I'll reintroduce. We've been here for 2 days now. This is the CMCA caravan park, it's the old showgrounds at Bundaberg. Been a great little place to stay. A few people have come and gone, there's plenty of room, and near enough to town, which is good. And nice big wide open sites. But you've got to be self-contained. You've got to have your, make sure you've got your water. There is water available at taps, but yeah, usually you have to either drive up to it or cart some with your tubs. You've got to be holding tanks and obviously toilets. So yeah, you've got your showgrounds. Yeah, it's a top little spot, and obviously you can hear one or two generators going. You can use generators as long as you don't use them any more than 2 hours at a time, and up to 4 hours for the day, which is good. Slightly over, it was a beautiful day, it's got a little bit overcast now, so there's a few people just catching up on last minute solar. So yeah, just learning as we go. Here we are, Bundaberg. And what is famous in Bundaberg? Ginger beer and rum. So yeah, the Bundaberg factory distillery, rum distillery, here we are. I've got to go to the information centre. She's just on the phone at the moment, so I said meet me in the information centre. I've got to see what's around here in Bundaberg to do, and then we'll go and have a look at the distillery. So I've been in the information centre, yeah, a few things to have a look at there. Mainly a bike ride, looking at doing a bike ride later. So I've just been back to the motorhome there and she's gone. So she didn't catch up with me in the information centre. I know where she'll be. Probably having a sample. We'll have a look. Righty-ho, at the iconic rum bottle at the Bundaberg Rum Distillery. Still looking for Jude, so we'll go and have a look inside. Just sitting down at the Bundy Distillery, enjoying a little taste. I have a little coffee chocolate liqueur, which is a yum. And you?
A Solarius.
Solarius, an aged one. She said, she went up and says, oh, I'm a Scotch drinker. And she said, he said, oh yeah, this will sort you out. Anyway, yeah, tour's just come back. Enjoying it, beautiful day. Feel that out there. Parked outside here at the Bundaberg Motorhome Park, and every night, you come home, well, about this time, what are we talking? It's just after 5. And up in that tree right there, I reckon you couldn't fit another rainbow lorikeet. They're all talking about what kind of day they've had. It's a fabulous sight. And then, of course, in the morning, just somebody says, I'm off. And there's a mass chirp and flutter, and off they go, and then it's peace and quiet. But these guys will calm down once they've run out of things to say. It's a fun night, listening to them all come home. Sure is a beautiful little spot down here at Bargara. Hopefully I've said it right. There's the town centre in behind me. And in front of me, beautiful views. Some people out there fishing on the point. It's a gorgeous day, beautiful Sunday. Have that ride. Here comes Jude past there now. Marathon going on as well while we're here. We'll cycle the path, hopefully Nelson's Park, Mon Repo, which is the turtle, up through to Oaks Beach, Burnett's Head, up towards the Burnett River, see how far we get there. Yeah, we've taken a wrong turn with our bikes. Ended up that close down to the beach. We'll just go back. But this is Mon Repo Turtle Breeding Beach. It's closed sort of around 15th October to the 30th of April, between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. Obviously the turtles come in here to breed. It's a beautiful beach, really pretty. Oh, well, we'll go and find the trail again. We've just gone past Monteripo Conservation Park where the turtles are, and we're making our way further on up the coast there towards the Burnett River. And what a day to be out. It's very, very pretty. So we just passed the turtle sanctuary, and we're going past, I think it's Oaks Beach, heading our way up. An interesting phenomena, or an interesting sight here is in the distance there, there's two poles. We go out here a bit, there's a marker, and you can't really, well, you could see it. There's another couple of poles there, and another couple of poles just to the left of that cabbage tree. And then there's another one out there to the right. So it's obviously marking the channel into the Burdett River, into the port, for all the big boats. We'll soon see as we get there a bit closer. A beautiful lighthouse. Small, miniature, it's been relocated. It was guiding ships into the Burnett River here at Bundaberg. We're going to find some more information. There you go, the historical Burnett Heads Lighthouse. There's some tours of every fourth Sunday of each month, 9 a.m. to 12. I'll walk up to the door. Yeah, we're going to make our way back now. Great ride, lovely day. We'll head back. Bit hard to see through the glass there, but a beaut little old truck at the Bundaberg ginger beer factory. Beautiful building, look at that, it's like an upside down ship hull. See what that looks like from that direction. That's a bit better, isn't it? Old Cliffy. Used in the 1940s and 1950s to deliver drinks to local houses. So it's a 1929 Chevrolet, restored in 2005. Looks beautiful. Here we are, arrival at the Bundy Ginger Beer Brewing Factory. See it through the doors. We are at the Bundaberg Ginger Beer Factory, enjoying some of the museum and the artifacts here. That was all the flavours there that you've just gone past, and here they've got the smells, so you can test which one the flavour is. We've got a testing at 10:30.
Hello.
Here's an interesting interactive display. You can go and push all these screens, and it sort of shows you what's been going on in the back of the factory. Yeah, really cool. So with the ginger beer, it looks like you got a grinding session there. Goes around to a brewing step, which is a wort mixture of ground ginger and the Queensland cane sugar and water. When it's heated, starches in the ginger break down, releasing a powerful zest. And it looks like it goes through heating. There we go, we've just finished the ginger beer tour. Highly recommended, very informative, and of course you get to taste all the 14 flavours. Interesting that Bundaberg ginger beer exports to 67 countries around the world. So yeah, here we are in the showroom and the items for sale. Here we are out of the strawberry shop, just out of Bundaberg. What do you got there?
Got some really nice strawberries for my breakfast, and I've just picked up a couple boxes of strawberries so we can do smoothies.